थैंक यू सो मच।
हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल। आई वेलकम ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स टू दिस सेशन ऑफ वेबिनार मिथ्स फैक्ट्स एंड स्कोप ऑफ जॉब इन गल्फ कंट्रीज फॉर फिजियोथेरेपिस्ट। होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एंड डूइंग वेल। फॉर दिस सेशन आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम आवर स्पीकर डॉक्टर भास्कर रेड्डी सर। He is a senior specialist physiotherapist working for Ministry of Health, Saudi Arabia. Dr. Bhaskar Reddy sir is a world-renowned physiotherapist, leading taping expert.
K-tape and dynamic tape.
He is trained in different specialties of physiotherapy. He has an experience of more than 14 years in physiotherapy, respiratory therapy, teaching, clinical and administration. He has experience of more than 5 years in Gulf countries. In Gulf countries like Qatar, Saudi Arabia, etc. At present, he is working as a senior specialist therapist in the Ministry of Health in King Khalid Hospital, Saudi Arabia. He is an advanced and spine rehab care director. He is an internationally well-known physiotherapist and well-known in the community. Like, he is international instructor in T-Max K-Tape in Korea. He has done his fellowship in clinical kinesiology taping from UK. He has also done international diploma in instrumental assisted manual therapy from Greece. He is certified in kinesiology dynamic taping in Canada, UK, Europe, and Australia, etc. He is a chief instructor for Physio Foundation India, Rehabilitation and Physiotherapy Practitioner Association, Physio Help Institute, and Helping Physio Academy. He is an editorial board member for International Journal of Physiotherapy and Research. He is the founder of Global Taping Society. He is an advisory board member in Indian Clinical Research Association, International Health and Fitness Association, Indian Academy of Dry Needling, and Global Outreach Medical and Health Association. Also, I would like all the participants, please mute their mic. Participants, please mute their mic so that the webinar goes smoothly. Participants, please mute so the webinar goes smoothly. Also, I would like to welcome Dr. Suchitra Golkar ma'am, Dr. Rajesh sir, Dr. Prakash sir, because under the guidance we are able to conduct this webinar. Before handling the session to Dr. Bhaskar Reddy sir, I would like to give some instructions to the participants. I request all the participants to keep their video on and audio off so there is no disturbance and the webinar goes smoothly. If there are any questions, please drop a message in the chat box. Our technical team will look after it. Answers to all your questions will be given at the end of the seminar. After this session, a feedback form will be circulated in the chat box as well as group WhatsApp groups. Please fill the feedback form so that we can improve for your benefit. I invite Dr. Bhaskar Reddy sir to start with the webinar.
Thank you. Thanks a lot, Shweta, for my introduction. Is my audio clear?
Yes, sir, your audio is clear.
Yeah. Yeah, thank you. Now, today, now, facts regarding the scope of physiotherapy jobs in Gulf countries. Many of us, after doing bachelor's degree or master's, will be planning to go abroad countries to earn money, or few people they have planned to settle there, or few people they would like to earn and they would like to come back to India. So many people have a question mark from where we have to start. Today I will be taking my webinar, especially this topic, so that almost your doubts will be clear. Now we will go to my presentation. Are you able to see this PowerPoint presentation?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Already Shweta introduction given about me. These are all the teams which helped me to conduct this webinar. Cornerstone and Physio Foundation of India and my hospital, King Khalid Hospital. I would like to thank once again. This is the box. I would like to thank once again Cornerstone team and Suchitra ma'am and Dr. Rajesh and his team. So this is the main topic, myths and facts. Many people will be telling like this, this is true or not, because people who will be working there will be knowing exact truth and facts. And most of the people also, they will not inform the what are the real things happening in that country, how to apply, what is the procedure, what is the pay scale there? That is a thing. Any Gulf countries, if you are planning to go there, there is not only physiotherapist, any healthcare professional, there is a procedure. They have to clear license exam. That is important and mandatory. Many people will be thinking, without license exam, can I work there? Very few centers, they will be taking, especially who are on dependent visas. I think maybe husband is working there, physio got married and she went there, she want to work, she is on dependent visa. Few of cases they will try without license exam, they would like to work there. It's a big centers. If they will catch you without license, the center will be closed and they will put a black stamp on you. So whole GCC countries, they have like Gulf countries, Dubai, Abu Dhabi, Qatar, Oman, Saudi, all these countries, you cannot work there. So keep in mind, exam is mandatory. If someone is telling no need of any license exam, you can work, no problem, means it's a big fake thing. And rather than fake, it's a more illegal. Just keep in mind. So you can see this PowerPoint presentation, this slide. These are all the main health regulatory bodies in countries like Health Authority, Dubai, it's called Abu Dhabi, had the exam which you will be writing. Dubai Health Authority is DHA, like Qatar, Saudi, Oman Board, and UAE. These are all the health board. You can see these emblems. And Gulf jobs. So main thing, you are going there to earn money. That is very important thing. So you will be having doubt. So what are the guidelines and what are the requirements to work as a physio or any healthcare professional in Gulf? If especially physiotherapist who is doing bachelor degree, completion after bachelor degree, you will be having internship of 6 months. After internship only, your experience will be counted. During internship, the experience will not be counted. That you just note this point, because this is very important. So after your internship only, your experience will be calculated. So for a bachelor degree holder, minimum 2 to 3 years is experience required to work any Gulf country. It will be depend on the country, like 2 years, 3 years. But for BPT, it is mandatory, minimum 2 to 3 years. Like master degree, it will be like minimum 1 to 2 years. You will be thinking, I finished, why still I want experience to work in Gulf? Because you didn't study in that country. So they will not knowing about your things, your credentials, everything. So they kept guidelines for people who are coming from another country. They should have minimum experience. That is very important thing. So license, how to apply license, where I can write exam. You will be having doubts, you will be having question marks, whether I can write in India or I have to go to that country to write. Especially in Western countries, most of the exams, you have to go to that country and write. Main advantage, Gulf exams, most of the Gulf exams, you can write it from India, except one country. I will tell that later. So, how to write? So, in this slide, I'm just giving like Dubai and Abu Dhabi. These are all the one of the very rich countries in Gulf. So I have given the links for Dubai and Abu Dhabi. So these license exams links are there. These countries, each country having their own license procedure. Some country procedure will be different. For Dubai and Abu Dhabi, keep in mind that initially you have to do data flow. Regarding the data flow, I will explain in the upcoming slides. Just keep in mind, there is a procedure. You have to do the data flow, then credentials, then you can write license exam, then you have to search for job. The validity will be like 1 year or 2 years. It will be keep on changing. This is regarding the Dubai and Abu Dhabi. And the second thing is Saudi Arabia. Keep in mind that in Saudi Arabia, previously you can directly write the exam from India, from Prometric site. But what happened? They are changing the rules. Now they kept one link called, there is one account, Mumaris Plus. So any healthcare professional, they have to create an account in Mumaris Plus. They have to submit their documents. These documents will be verified by Saudi Health Authority. Then they will issue an eligibility number. With that eligibility number only, you can write for Saudi. And keep in mind, Saudi in all the Gulf countries, scope of physiotherapy jobs is compared to other things, it's less. And especially government sector, now they are doing Saudi Asian. I mean to say that some specific jobs should be for their own nationalities. Other foreign nationalities cannot work. In that, they categorize dental and physiotherapy, some other healthcare professionals they added. Now anyone planning for Saudi means you cannot get a job in government sector. Maybe you can get a job in private sector. Private sector, when you compare government and private sector, your salary will be a little bit less. Especially Saudi scope is very less. You can ask me how you are working. I'm not working at present now. I have been working from past 5 years in Saudi. Now they are slowly removing the people who are working in Ministry of Health. They are giving the jobs to only Saudis. Previously, 3 years back, they are recruiting females, but they stopped recruiting females also in government sector, especially in Saudi Arabia. Another exam, one of the favorite and best choices, Qatar Prometric. In Qatar, I would like to say, you have to, no need to go for initially any data flow or anything. You can just go for Prometric site. You just register. You have to pay around $200 license exam fee, and you can write the license exam. That is very easy thing. Then when you will finish your exam, no, then you can apply for data flow. Same time, you can search jobs in Qatar. That will be very easy and good option. And the exam validity will be like 3 years. It's like 2 to 3 years. And Oman Prometric. For Oman country, you have to write the license exam, same thing. But this license exam, I would like to tell you that it will be valid for 6 months only. That is the thing. And during license procedure, you have to attend for interview. Same thing, it will be for Dubai and Abu Dhabi also. And one more thing, previously I told about this Qatar, no? Previously for BPT, MPT, you have to write, whether it's private or government, you have to write the exam. But for recently, they changed the rule for master degree people who is having 3 years more, 3 years to 5 years experience, they need not to write any license exam. This will be same applicable to Saudi also. Initially, I have written the exam, then they told they changed rules. So no of any exam. There will be an evaluation. We have to go to Riyadh. There they will conduct interview, like oral interview. For Kuwait, this is the only country where you cannot write license exam from India. So unless until if you got an offer, I mean during interview, if you are selected, the employer, I mean who selected you, no? He will arrange the things when you will go to that Kuwait country, no? So less than 3 months to 6 months, you have to write the license exam. They will apply, they will do the process, everything for the Kuwait. So you cannot write exam from India, this exam. And UAE, this is called United Arab Emirates. They have around 4 to 6 countries. And for this, the exam name is MOH, Ministry of Health. If you write this exam, you can work in these countries. So the link I have given down. And previously I mentioned data flow, especially for Dubai and Abu Dhabi. Any country, if you are planning to go to Gulf, data flow is very important and mandatory. You will be having question mark. What is a data flow? Data flow is a like one agency. All these Gulf countries, they have given this board to check the certificates. Your BPT or master degree qualification, I mean your educational qualification certificates, same time your experience certificates will be verified through data flow. Okay. And same thing, what will happen data flow, keep in mind, very important thing. Many of our physios will be having after BPT, they will be having their own clinics. It will be having question mark. I have my own clinic. Can I give experience certificate with my own name? In Gulf countries, your own clinic experience will not be counted. Uh, when you are applying for the license for data flow, you have to get center, you have to get the thing, or in your own clinic you have to keep someone, or if your wife or mother or someone as a like heading director or something, then it will not be counted. And also keep in mind, sir, I have experience in my own clinic, whether it will be counted for my job. Yes, it will be counted. Keep in mind that experience letterhead, your name should not be there as a director. Someone should be there. Same time, especially private sector jobs, they will be preferring the physios having clinical experience, like clinics, rehab centers, especially the employer, especially Ministry of Health, government sector jobs, when they are recruiting for hospital physio jobs, keep in mind, try to get an experience certificate from hospital. That is very important, because they will be considering only hospital experience. They will be given preference who worked in hospital. And many people, sometimes they will giving some fake certificates, or maybe the physios who worked in that rehab center, they have some issue with the management or with the hospital. They came out from that hospital, but you with your help of friend, you get the certificate and you apply data flow. Keep in mind, all the certificates will be verified. They will be sending a person, secret person, to your center, or they will send a mail to the center, or they will call to that person, HR department, whether this guy has been worked or not, any cases against him while doing treatment, any misbehavior, or whether his license has been suspended or hold. Because in India, most of the things, especially few states, they have their physiotherapy regulatory board, like a government organization, like Maharashtra OTPT Council, Gujarat Council, Physio Council, and there is no central council, or this is the problem. So your certificates, from where you got the things, will be verified. Keep in mind, very careful. And very important thing, keep in mind, after your physiotherapy, actually to work in any country, you should have license. In India, there need not any license to work as a physio. When you will finish your degree, you can work. But Gulf countries, they require home country license. As we don't have any central council, so who have been registered with like the state councils, or if they are having any organizations, if they are registered members of organization, so it will be considered as a license. So life memberships, previously they are accepting, now few countries they are not accepting lifetime membership. It should be like valid from 2 years, like 3 years, it's required. And if you are a BPT or MPT, post 2 years membership is required for any job. You will be telling, I have experience, I have these things, but keep in mind, post membership is required. Post membership will be considered as a license. So what is a post membership? I mean, see, I'm Bhaskar Reddy. I have, I'm Vice President in Physio Foundation of India. This is an organization. This is giving memberships to the physios. So they will consider this membership as a license. This is the example I'm given to you. Later we will discuss if any doubts. So this is the data flow. data flow is called primary source verification. This is the links where you have to submit your documents. You have to pay for each document, like BPT, like MPT. If you have experience, more than 5 experiences, so at least recent 3 will be considered, that you have to go for data flow. You will be having doubt. I don't know the procedure, links, how to do. I'm little bit weak in system. So some consultancies, they will do data flow for yourself. So you have to pay some amount. And also keep in mind, I have done data flow for Qatar. So now I got a job in Saudi. What I have to do? Can I use same data flow for that country? No. In one way, no. One way, yes. You can, what you can do is, from this country, you have to pay some amount. You can convert the data flow to that country. And also you will having one more question. I cleared my license exam for Saudi. Now I got a job in Qatar. Can I use same thing? No. Because each country license, own license exam is different. You cannot do. But for Dubai and Abu Dhabi, if you cleared one exam, you have worked there for 6 months, there is some chance to convert. These are all the data flow links and procedure. This is YouTube link. How you have to apply for data flow. How to transfer the data flow thing I mentioned. You have to go to data flow site. There you can able to convert, or if you don't know, your consultancies will do for you. And resume. Resume is very important thing. So your resume should not be more than 3 pages. It's depend. Minimum 2 to 3 pages. So in resume, you have to highlight your things, like your qualification, where your experience, and your passport details, your email and your contact numbers, and what are the workshop conferences you have been attended. If you received any awards, you can add these things. Very important things you have to prepare your resume. Don't worry about the resume. I will try to guide you how to prepare resume. I will try to give some model resumes also. Don't worry about that. Okay. It will be like a very big thing. Whatever, if you want, you can cut and you can use that. Job search. I applied for data flow. I cleared my license. Now what, how I can get a job? Job. I will answer your questions. I'm just seeing later. I will answer after finishing these things. So job search, how you have to do job search? Job search you can do by two things. Through newspapers, there will be like national newspapers or your regional newspapers. The consultancies will be sharing the advertisements, so on, so date. Some government or private sector coming to like Hyderabad, Delhi, Mumbai, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Chennai, they will be coming. Keep in mind, these job interviews will be happening in main metropolitan cities like Hyderabad, Chennai, Mumbai, Delhi, Kochi, Kerala, main important places. But that is one thing. And another thing where I will get, you have to create job. There are job, online job recruitment agencies will be there. You have to create some IDs like Naukari, Gulf Naukari, Job Monster. Okay. Consultancies like Jerry Varghese, Jessina. Anyway, some consultancies I'm giving here, and there you can search. You have to create your details, ID, everything, so that you will be receiving the jobs from the consultancies directly to our email, or you can visit their websites and frequently checking their jobs. Many of people, they will be having question mark. I cleared a license exam. I completed my data flow. I created a job ID. I submitted everywhere. I am not getting job. Why? Because the employer will see which is the best thing he can get. So he is having some requirements. He want a only female therapist, or he want only male therapist, or he want only bachelor degree holder, or he want only master degree, or he want only PhD. So accordingly, many people will be applying. So they will scrutinize. And the important thing I told, no, your resume. You will be giving 10 pages, 20 pages. They will not be having time to see 20 pages. Just they will throw. Important thing, which resume which be highlighting the important thing, they will see, oh, this is good. They will keep this side. So they will call for you interview. Whether the interview will be like a Skype or telephonic interview, or the employer will come directly to some hotel, you will be called for the interview. This is the normal thing happening. Or the employer will go for directly on Skype interview. This is important. Many people will be thinking, I applied my resume in different job portals. I received a job. Sometimes you will be receiving a mail that even you didn't apply for the job, you received Dubai job. They will be mentioning some $10,000 US dollars, $5,000 US dollars. Keep in mind, this will be fake job offers. And also they will send one document, they will tell to sign, and you have to send some amount to agency, they will issue visa. This will be fake. Don't worry about the fake job offers. I will be there and I will guide you if you will receive such things. And also some consultancies, they will contact you directly. They will tell, keep 10,000 or 50,000 to their account. They will give you a job. These are all the fake things which is happening. And don't worry, I will help you how to cross-check that. These are all the authorized consultancy agents in India for Saudi, and also for different countries like Dubai, Qatar. And you completed data flow, you completed a license exam, you got the job, you applied for the job, you selected in interview, then you will be having doubt. What else I have to do? Your certificates, here you have to do HRD, GRD, notary, and the country where you are going, attestation. Here you can see the one notary. So if you would like to go your original certificate, back of your original certificate, they will do notary initially. Then you have to apply for HRD. HRD means human resource development, HRD. So they will government, this is will be there from the government side. You can check in online also where HRD will be done. So it depends upon your state. Like Telangana means it will be done in Hyderabad. So major capital cities, they will do attestation. Even this attestation, they will be done by agencies, but they will be charging more. Just try to see, it's a very simple process, but you have to visit with your original documents. Sometimes they will be asking with offer letter. You have to see. So notary things, attestation, keep this will be like a last stage. This is not very important and urgent thing. When you will do HRD, no, then same thing when you are applying, same place only, GRD. This will be done by from Delhi. The place, no need to go to Delhi. It will be done where your HRD was done. There only they will keep one more stamp. So from Indian government, your certificates have been verified. This is called GRD and HRD. Then what you have to do? Which country you are planning to do go means like Saudi Arabia or Dubai, Qatar, Oman, any country. Their embassy will be in Delhi or in Mumbai. So there you have to go, you have to submit your certificates. Now these rules, they are changing. They are not directly accepting the certificates from you. So you have to apply through agents. So then you will do GRD, HRD. Then you will go for online to check the embassy. There the details will be there. How to do? This is called Ministry of External Affairs, ME. So this certificate attestation should be done. It will be done mostly from New Delhi or Bombay. Don't worry about that. If you have any doubts, you can contact me. I will help you. Don't worry. These are all the currencies. So you will be having doubt how much I will get. So this is the rough example I have given, like one Saudi riyal will be fluctuating depend upon the oil prices. So it will be equal to 19 rupees or 20 rupees. Qatar, Oman riyal like 190, like Kuwait will be very expensive, like UAE. So keep in mind that how much salary you are getting, same thing you will be spending for water. If you see means, you will be thinking in India, 1 rupee thing means in Saudi, like 19 rupees. So 1 Saudi riyal equal to 19 rupees Indian currency. If you would like to buy a water bottle, it will be like 1 riyal means, so you are spending 19 Indian rupees. So if one coffee or a tea, like 2 riyals or 1 riyal means, you will be spending around 40 rupees. That keep in mind that the cost of living will be varying. And cost of living will be depend upon the country. It will be expensive, like Dubai, Abu Dhabi will be expensive. And Saudi will be very less cost of living. If you are living in major capital, like New Delhi, Bombay, Calcutta, how cost of living will be there? Same with that country. And before that conclusion, I would like to add, so what is the minimum salary I have to work? It depends upon the country. It depends upon your educational qualification. It depends upon the employer, whether it's a private or government, whether it's a clinic, whether it's a hospital, whether it's a teaching job, whether it's non-teaching job. It will be accordingly. I will give you small examples like Qatar government sector, the salary starting will be like 9,000 riyal to even 25,000, 30,000 riyal per month. In Saudi, this is what I told in government sector salary. In private sector, salary will be around 3,500 or minimum 4,000 to max 10,000 riyal, less than that, 9,000, 8,000 riyal. Like that, you will get the salary. I would like to thanks once again Physio Foundation of India and Cornerstone. Special thanks to Suchita ma'am and Rajesh Sanghi and Dr. Prakash sir and his team. And not least our delegates, because these people around the globe, they shown interest to know about this webinar. And I would like to thank all my friends and my family members. Especially last but not least, these crabs. Because of these crabs, in any profession, it will be there. They will be even in your classroom or in your working area. These people will be trying to pull you. Don't worry about these people. Because of these people, you will be knowing how you have been pulling. So you try to move on your steps. Go ahead. Don't worry. Now we will start the discussion. What are the doubts?
Good evening, sir. Hello. Sir, am I audible?
Yeah, yeah.
Should I start asking the questions to you one by one?
Sir, first of all, I just want to ask you, sir, whatever links you have mentioned in the session or in the presentation, so can you just provide them to the participants because the participants are asking for the link?
Yeah, yeah, don't worry about the links, everything. 1 minute, I would like to one more thing.
Hello, sorry to disturb you, sir.
Yeah, 1 minute, 1 minute. Yeah, tell me.
Sir, the meeting is going to end in 2 minutes. So can we start the new meeting so that you can share what you are going to tell us in brief?
Yeah, yeah, you can.
Yes, sir. So I will
end this meeting. Same ID only?
Yes, same link, sir. Join the same link. Participants, join the same link.
Okay.
Prachi,
Prachi or Shweta, and whoever registered for this webinar, no, you can create a WhatsApp group.
So we do have a WhatsApp group. So we have two WhatsApp groups for the participants.
Yeah,
so
there you can... there you add my Saudi number.
Okay, sir.
I will try to answer them and I will try to guide them. And also the people who are registered, they can take these numbers. This is the my details. You can take a screenshot or you can take photo of this one. And one minute.
Can you please add register number in the WhatsApp group?
And you registered members, try to take this photo of this one, and also you can take photo of this so that I will be available, and also I am sharing the jobs here through this medium. Try to send a WhatsApp message to my Saudi number only. Most of the time I will be using Saudi number, and most of the time I will be available in Saudi WhatsApp number. And also you try to add me in your WhatsApp group so that if anyone having doubt, I will try to answer. And also if anyone having doubt, they can raise their hand and you can unmute that person so they can speak, so other people can able to hear also, rather than reading chat. This will be a good option, or no problem, as per chat we can go ahead with whatever the doubts they are having.
Sir, your Saudi number will be added to the WhatsApp group of the participants by Shruti.
Yeah.
So the participants can ask their further questions on the group.
Yeah.
So should we go for 2 to 3 questions?
Yeah.
So the first question is asked by Mudassir. So he's asking, if we have done MCT and have been working for 4 to 5 years in India, should we go for a government or a private hospital job in Saudi? And if we another question is also asked that if we have 4 to 5 years of experience in India, can we open our own clinic in Saudi Arabia?
See, that's a good question. Whatever, whether you are having BPT or MPT, I am audible.
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Yeah, whether you having BPT or MPT, what will be the average salary? I clearly mentioned you previously. Now in Saudi, they are not recruiting any other nationalities. Physiotherapy jobs only for Saudi nationalities. Only you can get a job in private sector. So the salaries average, I'm telling truth and facts. So it will be around 3,500. So don't go for 3,500. Minimum 4,000 riyal, and it should and average 4,000 to 9,000 riyal. If you will get this package only, you have to accept. And one more important thing I would like to tell all of you people: don't go for less salary, like 3,000 riyal, 2,000 riyal. You will be thinking that I'm going for less salary job. There I will search for a good job which is paying more. I can transfer. Keep in mind, these countries sometimes they will make you agreement to sign when you will come to that country, when you will sign for a limited contract and unlimited contract. Limited contract means will be 1 year or 2 years. Unlimited means like it will be like minimum five years, like minimum 3 years, 3 to 5 years, or more than 10 years also. So when you want to break the contract, you cannot work in that country. You have to come back to India. There will be travel ban on you. You cannot immediately go to that country, even if you have any other offer also. That is the reason, don't go for very less salary. That is very important thing. Many people, they don't know. They will go, they will sign. When you have some issue, when you are coming back, you will think that you can change, but you cannot change. There will be travel ban. So you cannot go to that country for minimum 6 months to 2 years. And one more question, as you mentioned, whether I can put a rehab center or clinic in the Saudi. Answer is, to be frank, no. But you can keep it unless until there will be like your one of the partner employer should be Saudi, because in Saudi or Gulf countries, if you want to start a business, anything, you cannot do directly. One of the partner should be that own country people, Saudi or Qatari or someone should be there. Then you can able to open. Yeah, next question.
So the next question is, so the Qatar data flow can transfer to Oman country to work? So it's asked by Raja Ram.
Data flow, any data flow, if you will do data flow from one country, like I have previously given, like Saudi, Qatar. So, okay, with Rajaram, I will give one explanation. He have done data flow for Oman. He completed data flow. When he got an offer for Qatar, whether this data flow can be used? Yes, he can use the data flow. He can convert. He has to go to website. He has to pay some amount, then it will be automatically convert from Oman to Qatar, because the same company only doing data flow. License exam you cannot convert, data flow you can convert. And keep in mind that you worked in Oman, you finished the contract. When you have done data flow, no, Oman experience is not added. So when you will go for Qatar, no, when you will get experience certificate in Oman, like till to date he worked, that recent one, no, you have to add for Qatar job. I mean for Qatar data flow, you have to do additional data flow. That, I mean, last experience certificate should be done. Next question.
So the next question is by Nupur. Can you please give an idea about MOH oral exam?
Yeah, oral exam. So whatever the Gulf country, especially like Dubai, Abu Dhabi or Oman, even for MPTs like Qatar and Saudi Arabia, what are the questions will be asked during interview? This will be a thing they will be asking about you. You have to tell, I'm so and so. At present, I'm working this hospital. What is the position? You have to explain them. Okay. Then they will be asking the questions from your subject. I mean, where you are working. There only you will be having questions. So it will be like any assessment, like a general assessment. Like if the interview will be conducted as previously it was conducted in hospitals, so their patients will be coming. So they will be giving one major and one minor conditions like MPT exams, like DPT exam. So you have to take assessment. You have to take subjective, objective assessment, a special test, everything. Then what is the treatment? Treatment, keep in mind, evidence-based practice. So they will be asking short-term goals and long-term. This goal should be measurable. Measurable goal is very important. You please make it note down. What is measurable? You will be writing even in your goals like to decrease pain, to improve range of motion, to improve strength, gait training. These are all goals, but not measurable. You cannot measure. You have to write a measurable goal like this: to decrease pain VAS scale from 7 to 3 within 5 days to 10 days. So your measurable goal should be like time variable. Everything should be there. It should be measured. Like I will improve range of motion, shoulder abduction from 90 degrees to 120 degrees from 5 days to 15 days or 1 month. Some date should be given. Not like I will improve his range from 90 degrees to 120 degrees after 1 year, after 2 years. Especially for long cases like spinal cord injuries or stroke conditions, assisted gait training within 1 month to 3 months, like independent gait training from 3 months to 1 year, like that you can write. This is called measurable goal. Okay. And these questions and special tests they will ask, you to show. In system, they will show any MRI or X-ray to identify that vertebra, which level, disc prolapse, like this. A special test, what you have to do, how to differentiate a differential diagnosis, why you choose this treatment, what are the parameters. This type of questions will be asked during your interview. Next question.
Cost
will be variable. See, I previously told no DHA, the procedure will be like data flow, credentials, license exam. License exam will be like I'm giving a rough amount because I have given the links. DHA, if you go for the exam, it will be like 10,000 rupees, like that Indian currency. I'm just explaining you 10 to 15,000 Indian currency for the exam. For a data flow, keep in mind that one educational qualification, if you have BPT, means like each certificate, it will be like 1500 to 3000. Depends. And if you are having the experience certificates, like one experience, so like it will be adding like 3000, 6000, 9000. So it will be variable. And also I would like to tell you the time. So for the data flow, it will be taking minimum 7 days to less than 3 months. because why I am telling this gap period means you have taken membership from one association. Data flow people, they send the mail, they are not replying. So your certificate, so unless until they will respond, no, up to that time your data flow will not be finished. That's the reason I am stressing the people, don't apply with stupid one few associations. They are, because of that associations, many Indian physios and foreigner physios, they suffered a lot. So you have to try to cross check which association is giving very fast their certificates. And also during data flow, no, when these people are contacting data flow, how fast they are responding. So depend upon that time only your certificates will be verified and you will get the data flow. That is the thing. Keep in mind, for Gulf jobs, I mean 2 years before membership should be required. That is important. Anyway, you will add in group, then I can explain them, or I will send the links. What is the data flow? Everything I will explain them.
Yes, sir. So there are many questions, but the further questions can be will be answered in the WhatsApp group. So you will be added shortly in the WhatsApp group, sir.
Okay. Try to add my Saudi number, huh?
Yes sir. Shruti will add your Saudi number only. Shweta, should I go forward?
Yeah.
We are at the end of the session. So hello everyone. Wow, what an event. It's really great that this webinar turned out to be very successful. I, Dr. Prachi Singhi, on behalf of the Cornerstone All India Student Organization, extend a very hearty vote of thanks. First of all, I would like to give my thanks to our speaker, Dr. Bhaskar Reddy, sir, for gracing today's webinar. Thank you so much, sir, for sharing such precious knowledge with us and so much facts about the job opportunities in Gulf countries. Thank you so much, sir. I would like to express a profound gratitude to Dr. Sujata Gola, ma'am, and Dr. Rajesh Sanghe, sir, for their moral support and guidance. I extend a very hearty vote of thanks to our honorable delegates who blessed us with their presence. Last but not the least, this event wouldn't have been successful without the support of the organizing team. Thank you so much to all the members of Cornerstone All India Student Organization for your efforts to make this webinar successful. So before concluding, I have an announcement. So as this organization is for students and by the students, so if anyone of you is willing to participate in this organization, please contact us on our email ID, which will be provided on WhatsApp group and was there on the flyer. Once again, thank you all. Thank you so much, sir, for a wonderful session.
Yeah, thank you. My pleasure.
Yes, sir. From Cornerstone organization, team members and all the participants, we thank you a lot, Dr. Bhaskar Reddy sir, and and the students will communicate with you personally if they have any doubts. Many students were asking questions. I have seen the Deepesh Rathi, he was also eager to ask the question, but he will now ask you on your personal WhatsApp group. And henceforth also, we will need your help in conducting such awesome and outstanding webinars. So please do cooperate and support us in future also. And
yeah, sure, madam. This hopefully this corona soon will end. Next year I will be coming India. Hope so. Yeah. I will come to college also, madam.
Yes. Thank you.
My
so
pleasure.
Much. So yes, thanks. Whenever you will be there, I am always communicating to you on your WhatsApp number. So henceforth also, any conferences there at Vishakhapatnam or Chennai, you please do inform us. So our organization team members will also attend that conference and we will do the required things as per your guidance.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Take care. Stay safe.
Hello. Hello.
Yes,
Rajesh sir.
Thank you, sir. Dr. Bhaskar Patil sir.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you for spending your knowledge. Our organization and student definitely student will be get a benefit from your knowledge, sir.
No, it's my pleasure, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
We will conclude this meeting, sir, then.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you all.
Yeah, thank you.